Hi, in this tip, we're going to talk a little bit about polygon selections. So I have a sphere and a few materials. So let's get started. In Cinema 4D, if you're in face mode, it works for edge and point mode as well, but a little bit differently. You can select a selection of polygons, and then you can save it for later. The easiest way to do this is to go to the Select menu and say Set Selection. It doesn't seem like anything happened, but we have a different view in our attribute manager, and we have a little triangular selection right here in our object manager. So Cinema 4D adds a tag that represents this selection. The most obvious use for it is to remember what you had selected. So if I select a different set of polygons now, I can click this selection tag up here, and I can say restore selection, hide others, select polygons, deselect polygons. So what I can do is I can sort of use this like a union or difference tool to modify my polygon selection. So if I say deselect polygons, it deselects the polygons that were a member of that selection. If you double click the tag, it simply restores the selection to what it was. So it's useful for that sort of stuff. Let's get rid of that tag and I'll show a more practical example. Let's say I wanted to color this like a beach ball. What I could do is select these polygons at the top and the polygons at the bottom and then set a selection with them. So I just go to my Select menu and say Set Selection. Now we have a selection that we can easily revert to. So we can just double click that. We can select those polygons, deselect them. So those are saved for all intents and purposes. Now we can do our beach ball pattern. Now I've already measured this sphere and it has 48 segments. So if we wanted six different colors, three pairs of colors, we could basically select groups of eight. Groups of eight. So we select that, and then we skip 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then we select, I'm just doing some counting here, like that. So we have our slices of our beach ball. But we need to deselect the top part here. Beach balls usually have a circle at the top and bottom. So the first obvious use for this is that we can just click our selection here and say deselect polygons. That was a really easy thing to deselect anyway, but I think it sort of shows a use for it. So now that we have this pattern selected, another really cool thing you can do with these selections has to do with materials. I believe in Cinema 4D 12, this feature was introduced, and you can simply drag a material, in this case the red material, onto your selected polygons. And what Cinema 4D does is it creates a polygon selection for those polygons and it automatically assigns it into the selection slot of the material. So I'm going to delete it just to show you how that works. I have white and then I have red on top of it. And if I wanted to color the top and bottom red, I can drag this polygon selection into the slot. If I wanted to color that selection I previously had red, I can drag that into the slot. Similarly, I can double-click this last polygon selection tag to select all those polygons, and then I can go Select, Invert Selection, and then I can go to my first selection tag, deselect polygons, and now I have all the other polygons selected. So I can color those yellow. So now I have sort of a beach ball. The polygon selections are pretty powerful. You need to get used to using them, but once you start using them, it seems like you could just use them for everything. Really quickly, before we wrap this up, I want to show you how the point and edge selections differ. Only real differences are with point selection, you select your points, and you go up to the Select menu and you say Set Selection, and the icon is points. So that's one of the big differences. When you double-click a selection tag, it switches you to that mode. So if I double-click the point selection, it switches me to point mode, selects my points. Edges works the same way. So if I wanted to select a few loops of edges and then save those as a selection for later, I can just say Set Selection and I get an edge selection tag. So you may have seen these tags generated automatically when you did certain things like booleans or converted a NURBS object to a polygon object, and these are really useful. You should start generating these yourself and using them to remember selections and assign materials. So this was a really basic tip, but I hope you guys enjoyed it, and until next time, see ya!